This video is about a problem on differential equation. So this is a problem from CSIR NET June 2019 physical science paper. So this is a higher order differential equation but linear and with constant coefficients. The equation is this t4x dt4 plus 2 omega square, so on. For omega greater than a, the particle will eventually come to rest at the origin, eventually drift to infinity, oscillate about the origin and eventually come to rest at something, some point. So basically one has to first understand what are the meaning of these options. So for example, eventually come to rest at the origin, this actually means when t tends to infinity, the x should go to 0. Eventually drift to infinity means, as it is written, mod x tends to infinity, but when t tends to infinity, oscillate about the origin means it has both positive negative values, but it does not go beyond something, there is a bound and it oscillates between them, and it does not go out of that bound and eventually comes to rest at this. So the last option means when t tends to infinity, the limit of x should be omega by a or minus omega by a. So this problem has actually two important steps. One has to first find the solution in terms of t, so solution of x in terms of t, and then one has to analyze that solution to find which one of these options is correct. So let's see how to solve such a differential equation. So first I have written the differential equation here, the same equation, and this condition is given for omega greater than a, we have to analyze the options basically. So of course this is a constant and this is a constant, and of course we can see this is linear. So linear differential equation, fourth order and with constant coefficients. So this has an auxiliary equation. This is well known, the auxiliary equation, which is nothing but lambda power 4 plus the constant whatever it is, then lambda square as it is d2x dt2, and the first one is lambda power 4 as it is d4x dt4, and then this constant as it was omega power 4 minus a power 4. So we can see that the first term lambda power 4 is lambda square square, then here lambda square and nothing here. So this is basically a quadratic in lambda square, so we can solve this quadratic in terms of lambda square actually, because this is a quadratic or a second degree polynomial in lambda square. So the lambda square is exactly equal to minus b, as we solve quadratic equations. This is minus b minus 2 times omega square plus minus whatever b square minus 4ac by twice a, here a is of course 1, we can see, so by 2, and therefore if we divide it by 2 we get this thing, minus omega square plus minus a square. But this is the value for lambda square, one has to find the values for lambda. So lambda is equal to plus minus again root over whatever it was, minus omega square plus minus a square. Now the condition given was this, omega is greater than a. We can check it in a moment that if omega is greater than a, then minus omega square plus minus a square is actually less than 0. So this term inside inside the square root, this is actually less than 0, this is a negative term. So therefore we will make this entry positive, but we will take minus 1 out, but under the square root. So we have taken minus 1 square root out, plus minus whatever it was, and then square root of omega square minus plus a square, this is nothing, we could also write plus minus. Now this entry is actually positive because we have taken minus 1 out, and therefore lambda is nothing but plus minus minus root is I, and these two values. So basically I have written separately so that it becomes clearer. So this is plus minus I for the negative value, it's omega square minus a square, and plus minus I omega square plus a square. Now this is a four order differential equation and it has four complex roots. These all roots are of the form, of course, alpha plus plus minus I beta, but here alpha is actually 0, this is actually 0. So these all these are from plus minus I beta, but we can see that betas are actually different. So we have four complex different roots, not only complex, they are imaginary only. So now we will try to write the general solution when we have four different lambdas and four different complex lambdas. So for example, suppose we have alpha plus minus I beta, then how do we write the general solution? In that case, we write x equal to, so here actually alpha equal to 0, so this is actually 0 here, and also here it is gamma, and gamma equal to 0 here. So the actually roots are plus minus I beta and plus minus say I delta. So delta is nothing but this, and beta is this. Now suppose the differential equation given is only of second order, and suppose that has roots plus minus I beta. In that case, we write x equal to a cos beta t plus b sin beta t. And similarly, if there is a second order equation whose roots are plus minus I delta, then we write again similarly x equal to c cos delta t plus d sin delta t and so on. Now if the equation is fourth order equation and there are four different roots, actually what we have to do to write the general solution is, first you write for plus minus I beta, which is this, and just add them. So we have to add the solutions. So for example, if there are complex roots which are not all distinct, then actually this is not the solution. This is not the solution. But if the four roots are distinct, complex, then this is the solution. And here of course the real part is 0. So this is, so exponential is not coming into this picture. So now if this is the general solution, we have to analyze the solution to find which option is actually correct. So first option is, so let's go to the options. First option is eventually come to rest at the origin. So if we take limit t tends to 0 in this equation, then x is definitely not 0, because sin t, sin some constant t, cos some constant t, they are never going to 0. For example, limit t tending to infinity sin t or maybe cos t, they are never 0, they actually don't exist. So therefore, x tending to 0 as t tending to 0 is never a possibility. So first option is not correct. Eventually drift to infinity as mod x tends to infinity. So if t tends to infinity, whether x goes to infinity, that is of course not the case, as we have already discussed, sin t, cos t, this limit actually does not exist. So also we can just write this. So whatever mod x is, the mod x will always be less than equal to mod a plus mod b plus mod c plus mod d. Why? Because this sine, cos, again sine, cos, their mod is always less than equal to 1. Therefore, mod x would be always less than equal to this number, whatever this number is. Because a, b, c, d are arbitrary constants, but once we put the constants, they are actually fixed. Therefore, mod x cannot go to infinity, because mod x is bounded always by this number. So mod x tends to infinity is not a possibility. So the second option is definitely not correct. So eventually come to rest at the last option, omega by a minus omega by a. So that is also not a possibility, because as we have just checked, as t tends to infinity, it has no limits. This is actually well known, sin t, cos t, this has, those functions have no limit. So last option is also not a possibility. And oscillate about the origin, this is the only option left, so this must be correct. But why oscillating about the origin? This is actually expected, because of the presence of sin t, sin cos, those functions. We know that they are of course oscillating, and their sum is in some sense oscillating, might not be exactly like sin or cos individually, but that will of course oscillate, because for some t, x will sometimes be positive, and for some t, x will sometimes be negative. And therefore, I mean this particle, whatever it is, will oscillate between some numbers. So the third option is correct.